President, please be seated.
Le président, veuillez vous asseoir.
The chamber is now back in session.
Reprise de l'audience.
The chamber would like to inform the
La chambre
co-prosecutors and the lead co-lawyer for civil party that your combined time is 20 minutes left.
Qu'il vous reste ensemble 20 minutes. La parole est passée au co-procureur.
Hello, Mr. Witness, can you hear me?
Monsieur le témoin, pouvez-vous m'entendre?
Parle.
Yes.
Sir, we talked this morning
l'accusation ce
about
matin,
how you had come across a funeral
nous avons
and
parlé
persons
de la manière
burning incense.
Vous êtes tombé sur des
and you told them it was okay, but if anyone found out, you could all get killed.
Vous leur avez dit, ça ira,
why was
si
it that people could get killed
cela,
for burning incense during the regime?
Risquaient-ils d'être exécutés pour avoir brûlé de l'encens sous le régime?
I do not know.
Réponse, je
but
ne sais pas.
I felt concerned.
Mais je me suis senti concerné.
Because they did not believe in a ceremony at that time.
Car on ne croyait pas aux cérémonies.
When you
à
say they did not believe in ceremony, can
l'accusation.
You explain what was the policies
on ne croyait
you were
pas aux
instructed
cérémonies.
On
pouvez-vous nous dire
regarding Buddhism?
Quels ordres
what did the,
vous avez
your superiors tell you about the practice of religion?
Que vous avez dit vos dirigeants au sujet de la pratique de la religion?
Because I did not see the
réponse.
Pagodas, so I felt that they did not believe in a religion
je
anymore.
N'avais pas vu de pagode.
Well, sir,
je
as a former monk, you must have been interested in that subject.
L'accusation.
In your heart, did you remain
ce sujet doit
a
vous
Buddhist?
Intéresser. Dans votre cœur, êtes-vous resté bouddhiste?
Yes, I have always believed in the
oui,
religion.
J'ai toujours cru en la religion.
But during the regime, is it correct you didn't practice
l'accusation.
Your religion, or
mais
if you did,
régime,
you kept it hidden?
Est-il
is that
exact
correct?
Que vous ne pratiquiez pas la religion, ou du moins vous teniez cette pratique cachée? Est-ce exact?
But
under that circumstances,
réponse.
I thought it was right.
Dans ces circonstances,
well, why is that? What did you think?
Qu'il était adéquat.
Why did you think that it would be dangerous to admit or to let people know you were practicing?
Question. Pourquoi pensez-vous qu'il était dangereux que des gens sachent que vous pratiquiez la religion?
Bye.
As I told you earlier, I felt concerned.
Réponse, comme je vous l'ai dit, je me sentais concerné.
If we conducted without any permission,
je me sentais préoccupé.
Sir, how did you learn about the policies?
Car nous le
did
faisions sans permission. L'accusation,
some
comment
books
avez-vous appris?
Or
eu des informations
newspapers
au sujet de cette politique.
Or instructions?
L'avez-vous appris?
Did you attend meetings? How did you know what was allowed and not allowed during the regime?
Avez-vous reçu des instructions à cet égard? Comment saviez-vous ce qui était permis et ce qui ne l'était pas sous le régime?
Related to this question,
réponse.
I feel that it's difficult to give the answer.
Il est difficile de répondre à cette question.
Because I think the answer is beyond my knowledge.
Car je
sir,
estime que cette réponse
Nunchia, Pol Pot,
dépasse
Sampan
mes
during
connaissances
the regime?
Avez-vous rencontré Pol Pot, Nguyen Chuy et Khieu Samphan pendant le régime?
I never met them personally.
Je ne les ai jamais rencontrés personnellement.
And yet, in Thet Sambat's book that I quoted,
dans le livre de Thet Sambat que j'ai cité, il parle de vous.
Quoting from Pol Pot, he said Pol Pot asked where people were going, who were going to be executed.
Pol Pot a demandé où les gens allaient être exécutés.
And in the audio tape I played of your interview,
audio de
you talked about attending meetings
que
with Nguyen Chuy.
Vous parlez.
Is it still your position now in court under oath that you never met any, never saw any of these leaders?
À savoir que vous n'avez jamais vu ces dirigeants.
I cannot recall everything.
Réponse.
Because it happened a long time ago.
Sir, my colleague has some questions for you. I'm out of time. Thank you.
L'accusation, j'en ai terminé.
First of all, I would like to say good afternoon to the chamber and to the bench. My name is Xing
Lien. Tout d'abord, je dirais bonjour au parti et à la chambre. Je suis
Xing Lien, the deputy national co-prosecutor. Today I have a number of questions to put to the witness.
Le substitut du co-procureur
national. And I would like the witness to clarify to the chamber.
J'ai quelques questions à poser au témoin.
I am interested in a time when you were transferred.
Je m'intéresse à une époque ou à la période où vous avez été transféré dans le district de Baraye.
Can you tell us again about when you were transferred to work in Baraye district?
Quand est-ce que vous avez été transféré dans le district de Baraye pour y travailler? Réponse.
I can remember some of the time. It was in August.
Je me souviens que c'était en août.
In 1978.
En 1978.
Question.
Question.
When you arrived in Baraye district.
À votre arrivée dans le district de Baraye.
Were you aware of the dam building or dike digging?
Answer,
yes, I was aware of it because when I arrived there, I saw the digging of canal.
De construction des digues. Réponse oui,
and
j'étais au courant
car
à mon arrivée,
completed. It was about 80% accomplished.
Que l'on creusait des canaux. Le travail
question,
était pratiquement
could
achevé à 80%.
Could you elaborate more about this?
Question. Pouvez-vous
answer,
nous en dire plus?
I myself
réponse,
went to dig
je suis allé
and
moi-même
carried earth at a place called Phnom Kapal.
Creuser de la terre à Phnom Kapal. Creuser et transporter de la terre.
Question: when did you go to the Phnom Kapal work site,
quand
and what did you do there?
De travail de Phnom Kapal et qui
and what were the people
fait?
There doing?
Que faisaient les gens qui s'y trouvaient? La réponse.
I participated in digging.
J'ai participé
with the people there.
Avec les personnes aux travaux consistant à creuser.
I also carried
la terre.
With them.
J'ai également transporté la terre avec eux.
Because it was an intensified plan to finish it. And that was why
il y avait un plan intensifié consistant
participated
à
in that project so that we could have water to be used.
Raison pour laquelle j'ai participé à ce projet
question.
Pour que nous puissions
so
avoir
could you
de
tell
l'eau
us how long did you
à
spend
utiliser.
There?
Question. Combien
answer.
De temps y avez-vous passé? Réponse.
I went there once every day, and I carried earth four or five times.
Tous les
and
jours,
beside that, I went to the paddy fields.
Je transportais de la terre quatre ou cinq fois.
Question.
En outre, je me suis rendu dans les rizières.
You told us that
question.
You went there every day.
Vous nous avez
is that
dit
correct?
Que vous y alliez
answer.
Tous les jours. Est-ce exact?
Yes, that's correct.
Oui, c'est exact.
Question.
Question.
So at the Phnom Kapal work site,
au chantier de Phnom Kapal,
was there any inauguration of the opening of the work site?
Y a-t-il eu une cérémonie
d'inauguration
du chantier?
No, there was no inauguration.
Réponse non.
of the launching of the work site.
Il n'y a pas eu
but they require us to make sure that we complete
Mais
it
on nous a demandé
within 1 or 2 months.
De nous assurer que le travail serait achevé
Question.
En l'espace d'un ou Were de deux mois.
Any Question. Leaders from the center or from the zone
des dirigeants du centre
who came to inspect the work site?
Qui sont venus inspecter le chantier.
Answer.
Réponse.
Yes, there were people from the
oui.
sectors and also occasionally there were visits from people from the center.
On recevait la correction visite from des the zone. Des zones.
Question.
Question.
Was that work site belong to the sector or the zone?
Ce chantier relevait-il du
Answer,
secteur ou de la zone?
To the sector.
Réponse, il relevait du secteur.
Question.
Question.
Who supervised the work site?
Qui supervisait
Answer,
ce chantier?
It was the sector.
Réponse, c'était le secteur.
The work site continued from 1st January dam. Question. So you mean that the sector controlled the work site?
Vous dites que le secteur contrôlait
so
le chantier.
If the sector controlled the zone, correction, if the sector controlled the work site, what about the zone?
Si le secteur contrôlait le chantier.
Answer. The sector
Qu'en
controlled the
zones?
Zone. But the district and the zone also involved in the project.
Mais le district et les zones étaient également impliqués dans le projet.
Question: Can you tell us about
Question.
The names of the person in charge of the work site and
le
the
nom,
zone?
Le nom
Answer,
des responsables du
the name of the person
zones.
In charge of the zone was
Réponse.
Kao Po.
C'est Kao Po qui était le responsable de zone.
And Pua was in charge of the sector.
Et Pua était
Question.
Responsable du secteur.
How many people Question. Were involved in the
Combien
building
de personnes
that work site?
Participaient aux travaux
Answer.
De construction sur ce chantier?
Approximately, there were 300 people.
Environ 300 personnes.
Because it was not a big area.
Car il ne
Question,
s'agissait pas,
can you tell us again whether it was 300 or more than that?
Question, pouvez-vous nous dire si
Answer,
c'était 300 personnes ou plus?
Was nearly completed when I arrived.
Réponse, le projet était pratiquement terminé quand je suis arrivée.
Question, Mr. Witness, there was a document
Question, Monsieur le témoin,
based on your interview with DC Cam. Is
E3 votre entretien avec le CDCAM
9149
3 bar 91
49
ERN en anglais
01 1 6 1 5 0 5 0
en Khmer
0073 1 2 4 9 3 2 9 4 French 01 0 1 0 1 0 3 4 2 3 5 In the document you said
3 5 Vous dites dans ce document
The question posed to you was did
La
you went to the work site?
Vous êtes posé vous êtes-vous rendu
Answer,
sur le chantier?
Yeah, I went
Réponse,
to Kampau
oui,
work site.
Je suis allé sur le chantier de Kampau.
There were tens of thousands of mobile unit
Il y avait des dizaines
personnel
de milliers
involved in the
de
project.
Membres de l'unité mobile
And I,
impliqués dans ce projet.
When I saw the children of other people,
Lorsque
I felt sympathetic toward them, and I said that I would let them to visit home every 10 days.
Et j'ai dit que j'allais les autoriser à se rendre chez
pre-translation.
Eux tous les 10 jours.
So what is your opinion or response to your, the answer you gave to the DCCAM interview?
Quel est votre avis? Sur cette réponse
Answer,
que vous avez donnée,
initially there were many people involved in the project,
réponse
but later on
début,
there were
y avait plusieurs personnes
less
impliquées
and less,
dans le
and there were
Mais ce nombre
only around 300.
A continué à diminuer jusqu'à atteindre
and I told
300
them
uniquement.
That I would let them to
je leur ai dit
visit their home, their
que
parents,
je leur permettrais d'aller chez
because,
eux, rendre visite à leurs
I
parents,
felt sympathetic toward them because
car j'ai prouvé envers eux de la sympathie.
I myself had that experience. My own niece and nephews were also sent to the work site, so I understood the situation. Co-prosecutor, thank you. Could you please give your answer short and precise?
Merci.
A while ago, you mentioned that initially there were many people involved in the project.
So could you tell us
how many of them, when you mean that many of them involved in the project? Answer, when I said many,
réponse.
I referred to
lorsque je parle
about
5
or 6,000 people.
Je vais parler de 5 à 6 000 personnes.
Question. Can that number reach tens of thousands of people?
Ce chiffre peut-il atteindre des dizaines de milliers de personnes?
It can reach tens of thousands of people at the initial stage.
D'après mes estimations, à un stade initial.
I would like to ask the lead co-lawyer for civil party whether you have questions for the witness.
Si le co-avocat principal pour les parties civiles ont des questions à poser au témoin.
Lawyer. I do not have any question to put to this witness. So I give my time segment to the co-prosecutor.
Je n'ai pas de questions à poser. Et j'accorde de mon temps au
co-procureur. Co-prosecutor, you can continue.
Le président.
Co-prosecutor, how many time left for me? Answer from the president, 10 minutes left.
Combien de temps me reste-t-il, monsieur le président? Thank you, Mr. President. 10 minutes, dit le président.
Mr. Witness, a while ago.
Merci, monsieur le président. Monsieur le témoin.
You based on the document that I referred to, you mentioned that there were tens of thousands of people who participated in the project.
Vous avez dit,
but you said a while ago. So what do you actually mean by this?
Participé au projet.
Qu'entendez-vous
Answer.
Par là? I mean that when the project was still small.
When it was just started for about 1 or 2 months. Son état embryonnaire.
Question. At the Kampawi work site.
Il avait été lancé pour 1 à 3 mois uniquement.
Did you issue any particular plan to be implemented by your subordinates?
Établi un plan quelconque devant être Answer. Mis en œuvre par vos subordonnés.
We issued the implementation of the plan based on.
Nous avons établi un plan à mettre en œuvre.
Based on months, 2 months or 3 months plan.
Sur 2 ou 3 mois.
Question.
C'était un plan sur 2 ou 3 mois.
Did you
question.
Order the enforcement of particular order, for example, each person had to accomplish a particular amount of work
exemple,
per day.
Chaque personne devait accomplir Answer, un volume de travail particulier par jour.
Cooperative
réponse.
Had to follow the order from the upper level that they had to accomplish within 3 months. So each group and unit had to follow the order which were assigned to them for a particular amount of work that they had to accomplish.
Question.
So after the units or cooperative finished their work, they reported to you or someone else?
Answer.
After we reviewed their work,
réponse, après avoir examiné
they reported to me, and then
travail,
I reported further
leur rapport, et moi,
to the upper level.
De les transmettre à l'échelon supérieur.
Question, were there any units
question.
Or group which could not accomplish the assigned work?
Ou de groupes qui n'arrivaient pas à achever le travail
Answer,
leur était confié.
No, there weren't.
Réponse, non.
Question, in the dam building, did you give any equipment to
the
to those cooperative? Whether they build it with the machine or manually? Answer: they build the dam manually.
Travaillait-il manuellement? Réponse:
and they also used the explosion powder to explode the rock.
Ou des explosifs pour briser la roche.
During the
Question.
Working, was there any point of time when the worker were required to work at night time?
À un moment donné, answer, les travailleurs devaient se travailler pendant la nuit. Réponse, non.
Question.
Question.
What about the accommodations of workers?
Qu'en est-il du logement des travailleurs?
Answer. They stayed in tents or in makeshift cottages based at the work site.
Ou des abris de fortune construits sur le site de travail.
Question.
Question.
Were there enough accommodation
to accommodate all the workers?
Were there any individual workers who did not have accommodation?
Y en avait-il
Answer.
Qui n'étaient pas logés?
Yes, there were.
Réponse.
Makeshift cottage for them,
oui,
but I can say that there were not 100% sufficient accommodation for all the workers.
Mais ces abris ne suffisaient
Question.
Pas pour accueillir
were there
les
any
ouvriers.
Children or women who also
Question.
Worked at the work site?
Y avait-il des femmes et des enfants qui travaillaient sur le site?
Yes, there were youths and
Réponse,
women
oui, il y avait des jeunes
from the mobile units.
Et des femmes
President,
de l'unité
your time
itinérante.
Has run out, co-prosecutor.
Co-prosecutor,
thank you, Mr. President. I have one question
Votre
left.
Votre temps est arrivé à échéance.
Mr. Witness,
Merci, Monsieur le Président.
Can you tell
J'ai
us
une toute dernière
when
question.
The construction
dire,
of the worksite completed and who presided over
achevé,
the
le travail de construction.
Completion of the worksite?
Et qui présidait aux travaux?
Answer. It was completed later
Réponse.
On.
Le travail a été achevé plus tard.
But the ceremony to close it took place
Mais la cérémonie
earlier.
De fermeture a eu lieu plus tôt.
Question.
Question.
Can you tell us who presided over the closing ceremony of the work site?
Qui présidait la cérémonie de clôture du chantier?
Answer, it was from the zone level.
Réponse.
Question, are you referring to Kai Pok?
Pensez-vous
Answer,
à Kai Pok?
Yes, Kai Pok.
Question, réponse oui, Kai Pok.
President.
Le président.
Thank you, co-prosecutor. And now I give the floor to
Merci
the defense counsel
tu vas
for
présent passer
Nunchi.
La parole au conseil de la défense de Nunchi.
Good afternoon, Mr. President. Good afternoon,
Bonjour,
parties, and good afternoon to you, Mr.
Bonjour.
I will be asking you some questions on behalf of Mr. Nunchi.
Je vais vous poser les questions
to explain to you in advance, I intend to be revisiting a lot of what you had discussed with the international prosecutor this morning, but I'll be doing so from a different angle.
Ce matin, mais je le ferai
so
d'un angle
to
différent.
Begin, I want
Pour
to refer
commencer.
You back to the last questions
la
the prosecutor asked you before the lunch break.
Avant la pause déjeuner.
As you might recall, he asked you about whether
Comme
you were ever
souvenez,
required to investigate people
si on vous avait
and what the policy on enemies
was. Sur des
so by way of explanation, my first questions relate to this general context.
Ma première question a donc trait à ce
Now what
général.
I want to do is to begin by reading you something that you said in your statement
de ce que vous
to
avez
DC
dit
CAM.
Dans votre
and
entretien
again,
avec
this is something that you've discussed a lot with the prosecutor this morning.
Vous
Mr. President, this is document E3/9149 from the 19th of June 2008. The ERNs I will be reading from for this quote are, in English,
01-11-61-47.
In Khmer,
00-73-12-44-5.
And in French,
01-10-10-31.
Mr. Witness, this is the quote that
Monsieur
I want
Dumont,
to read
la citation que je vais vous lire. Je cite,
To be honest, I did
honnête,
not report or point out about the background of any individuals.
Je ne faisais pas rapport,
this was not my stance.
Le passé de qui que ce soit.
As
ce
I told
pas
you,
ma position,
I was also
dit.
An outsider who came
J'étais
from a distant place.
Également
and then a little later, you go on to say, quote,
une personne qui venait
I did not know the history
éloigné.
Of the people or their relatives in the village.
Et en réponse, vous dites, je ne connaissais pas
so I informed
la biographie
my deputy secretary
personnes,
and
leur...
all the members that the upper echelon assigned me to keep an eye on those whose activities were against the party at that time.
Pour lesquels l'échelon supérieur m'a demandé
Unquote.
De superviser les activités.
And here is the question, Mr. Witness. My understanding of your statement is that you did not report individual backgrounds, but were focused instead on keeping an eye on activities against the party. My question is my understanding correct?
Les personnes qui menaient des activités hostiles au parti. Est-ce que ma compréhension est exacte?
In my opinion,
réponse.
That is correct.
À mon avis, c'est exact.
I did not know those people,
car je ne connaissais pas ces personnes,
told the chamber this morning.
Comme je l'ai dit à la chambre ce matin.
Thank you, Mr. Witness. And I should have said this earlier,
Merci, but this quote, when
you were saying this to DC Cam, you were speaking about your time in Barre District. So that's just for background for you.
De l'époque,
my next question is, do you know whether any other district secretaries or other cadres in authority positions also took a similar approach to you, focusing, that is, on activities rather than individual backgrounds?
Des personnes prises individuellement.
I did not have full grasp of this aspect.
Je ne maîtrisais pas totalement cet aspect.
That's not a problem, Mr. Witness. Let's talk a little bit more, though, about this idea of activities, because this is something that you elaborated on in some of your previous written statements.
Car vous avez développé ce point dans d'autres
according to your understanding, what kind of activities would be considered activities against the party?
Considérées comme étant hostiles au parti.
Activities considered opposing the party at that time were, for example, those who burn rice or poison people by putting the poisonous substance into the collective rice cooker,
du poison dans le riz.
Thank you, Mr. Witness. That actually nicely relates to the next thing that I wanted to discuss with you. You spoke about similar activities in your written record of interview to the investigating judges of this court on the 14th of July 2009. So although you've just discussed that now, I will go over what it is that you said to the investigating judges because you added a little more detail there. Mr. President, this is document E3/5293. As I said, it's the WRI from the investigating judges, and the ERNs that I will be referring to are, in English, 00-35-17-05-26. In Khmer, 00-34-88-45. And in French, 00-36-77-52. Mr. Witness, this is what the discussion was with the investigating judges. Was it the role of a cooperative to report about the issue of security to the upper echelon?
De signaler des problèmes de sécurité à l'échelon supérieur?
Yes, it was. For example, regarding the poisoning in the food. And a little later, the investigation continues. Quote, question, did anyone violate the policy of the UNCAR? Answer, no. However, there were light offenders, which included those who came to work late, and they were advised. They used the term self-criticism at that time. These misconducts were not reported to the district. And then a little further, the investigation continues.
Question,
how serious was one's misconduct to have him or her brought to the district? Answer, major misconducts included burning paddy fields. Question, to where were those with serious misconduct taken? And your answer? They were taken to be re-educated for 2 or 3 days in a sub-district.
Mais il n'y avait pas de tels incidents chez moi,
end
dans mon
court.
District.
Mr. Witness,
où amenait-on
my understanding
ces
of your answers in that interview
on les amenait en rééducation
there were two kinds
jours dans
of
la
offenses
commune.
And punishment.
D'après ce que je comprends, il y avait
so
deux types
let's talk first
de fautes
offenses.
Et de sanctions.
It seems
parlons
you were
d'abord
describing
des
light offenses
vous
on the one
des infractions
hand
mineures
and major misconduct
légères,
on the other.
D'une part, et les
can
fautes
you
graves,
give a reaction to this
part,
and let me know if my understanding is correct?
À ceci, pour me dire si je vous ai bien compris.
Yes, that's correct.
Réponse, oui, c'est exact.
Thank you, Mr. Witness. Now let's focus on the first type of offense I just described, which are the light offenses that you spoke of.
Le premier type de faute ou d'infraction.
Do I also understand correctly that according to your understanding, the punishment for light offenses would be to do some self-criticism, but that these offenses would not be reported to the district?
Qui commettent des fautes légères étaient des séances d'autocritique. Mais ces fautes n'étaient pas signalées à l'échelon supérieur.
Yes, because the offenses
réponse, oui.
Were considered as a misconduct that could be
car ces infractions
settled at the commune level.
Étaient considérées comme des fautes qui pouvaient être
thank
réglées.
You. And still talking about light offenses.
Au niveau du district.
Is my understanding also
question.
Correct that light offenses would include,
légères.
For example, activities like
exemple,
coming in late to work?
Des activités comme arriver en retard au travail, n'est-ce pas?
Yes,
that is considered.
Ça, c'était considéré comme des fautes légères.
Mr. Witness,
question.
Can you give any other examples of activities that would be considered light offenses?
D'activités considérées comme des fautes légères. Réponse.
As I stated in my previous statement,
comme je l'ai déjà indiqué,
light offenses included coming late to work.
Il y avait le fait d'arriver en retard au travail parmi les fautes légères.
Okay, Mr. Witness, now I'll
La
move
défense.
On to the second
Bien,
type of offense you've described,
au deuxième
which
type
is
de
what
faute.
You called major misconduct.
Les fautes graves,
so first question,
comme vous les avez qualifiées.
Do I understand
Première
correctly
question.
That, according to you,
D'après
the punishment for these offenses would be being reported to the district in this case and then eventually being re-educated for maybe 2 to 3 days in a sub-district.
Ensuite, 2 ou 3 jours de rééducation à la commune. N'est-ce pas?
Bah.
Réponse.
Yes.
C'est exact.
That is the case.
Question.
Same sort of questions as last time.
Même genre
is
de question.
My understanding also correct that when it comes to offenses of major misconduct,
concernant
these types of
les
offenses
fautes graves,
included, as you said,
elles incluaient,
poisoning
selon vous,
food and burning
le fait
paddy fields.
D'empoisonner de la nourriture et de bouter le feu aux rizières. N'est-ce pas? Réponse.
These offenses were determined that it were serious offenses. However, such offenses never
grave.
Happened
Toutefois,
at my location.
Aucune faute de ce type n'a jamais été commise là où j'étais.
I do understand that part, Mr.
Question.
Witness, and we will
Je
get to that.
Bien.
Just one final question on these offenses, even if they
fautes.
Didn't occur in your area.
Même si
Can you
fautes
give
n'ont pas
me
été commises
any
là où vous étiez?
Other examples of other activities that would also have been considered major misconduct?
Comme des fautes graves.
Bah.
I cannot respond to your question regarding this matter.
Je ne peux pas vous répondre sur ce point.
No problem at all, Mr. Witness.
Aucun problème.
I'm now going to read you another quote from your written record of interview so that we can discuss a little bit more some specific comments you made regarding food poisoning. Mr. President, this is once again the written record of interview with document number E3/5293 dated 14 July 2009. The URNs that I'm going to be reading from are in English 00351705, in Khmer 00348845, and in French 00367752. Mr. Witness, this is the quote. Quote, and the question from the investigator is as follows.
D'abord, la question de l'enquêteur.
Was it the role of the cooperative to report about the issue of security to the upper
les problèmes
echelon?
De sécurité à l'échelon supérieur?
Your answer.
Et votre réponse?
Quote, yes, it was.
Oui.
For example, regarding
Par
the poisoning
exemple,
in the food.
Concernant
and then you say, as you just said now, as a matter
ensuite,
of fact, there
dites,
was no such case.
En réalité,
but it was just
cela
a precaution.
C'était une simple précaution. Et vous l'avez
Question,
répété aujourd'hui.
Was there ever an incident of poisoning in the food?
La question suivante.
Answer,
y a-t-il
no.
Eu jamais
it might happen
des cas
in other sectors.
Empoisonnée? Et votre réponse,
the sector
non.
Was the body
Peut-être
that set
secteurs,
out this plan.
C'était le secteur qui établissait ce plan.
Mr. Witness, a few questions in reaction to this quote of yours. The first question is, do you agree with your prior statement that it was the sector that set out the plan about reporting security incidents to the upper echelon?
Concernant le fait de signaler à l'échelon supérieur les incidents relatifs à la sécurité. Réponse.
Yes, my previous statement is correct.
Je maintiens mes déclarations antérieures.
Do you also remember Question. Who it was in the sector that communicated this plan to you?
Qui vous a communiqué ce plan? Réponse.
It was Eun, and I mentioned his name previously.
J'ai déjà évoqué son nom.
Now, I understand, Mr. Witness, that you said that this kind of incident
Vous avez dit
of food poisoning, of burning paddy fields, did not happen in your area.
Pas eu d'incident de ce type là où
Do
vous étiez,
you know, however, whether these kinds of incidents happened in other places,
ou de
perhaps other districts,
à
Savez-vous other
si
sectors?
Cela a eu lieu
Do you have any knowledge
ailleurs,
of this?
Autre district, autre secteur. Le savez-vous? Réponse.
No, I did not. I did not know
non,
whether it happened in
je
other sectors
ne sais pas
or areas.
Si ça a pu se produire dans d'autres secteurs ou ailleurs.
No problem, Mr. Witness.
La défense, aucun problème,
Those
Monsieur
are all the questions that I wanted to ask you about this
J'en ai
issue
fini
of activities.
Pour mes questions
and now I want to move on to
activités.
Another topic.
Maintenant, je passe à un autre thème.
Now, you'll recall from earlier today that the international prosecutor has asked you several questions
vous a posé
concerning the existence of an enemy policy.
L'existence d'une politique
I would
relative
like to ask
aux
you
ennemis.
About a meeting that you described in your written statements, but which has not yet been discussed today. Do you, Mr. Witness, recall attending a meeting at
Barai
District,
district de Barai,
where your district deputy secretary
le secrétaire
announced
adjoint du district
what kinds of people would be considered as enemies?
Quel type de personnes seraient considérées comme des ennemis? Réponse.
No, I cannot recall that.
Non, je ne m'en souviens pas.
Mr. President, with your leave, I propose to read a section of the witness's DCCAM interview to try to refresh his memory.
De la déclaration du témoin au CDCAM pour tenter de lui rafraîchir la mémoire.
The document that I'll be reading from is once again
E3/9149,
the DCCAM interview. And the ERNs I will be reading from are, in English,
01-11-6151,
in Khmer,
00-73-12-50,
and in French,
01-10-10-36.
Mr. Witness, as I just explained, This will be an extract from your statement to the investigators from the Documentation Center of Cambodia. And here is the quote. Quote, my district secretary, my deputy secretary of Barai district made a public announcement that people who broke a plow, a harrow, or an ox cart would be considered as the enemies. Those who did not go to work were also considered the enemies.
Comme des ennemis, tout comme ceux qui n'allaient pas au travail. Fin de citation.
Mr. Witness, does this refresh your memory about a meeting at Barai District in which your district deputy secretary announced what kind of people would be considered to be enemies?
Le district a annoncé quel type de gens seraient considérés comme des ennemis.
Bah.
Yes, I recall that Tan was the deputy secretary of the district and who made that statement.
C'est lui qui a dit cela.
Mr. Witness, do you remember how you reacted to this announcement by your deputy district secretary?
Quand le secrétaire adjoint de votre district a annoncé cela?
After the announcement had been made, people were
fearful. Quand ça a été annoncé, les gens ont pris peur.
And later on, I held a meeting to make announcement to the
j'ai
people.
Organisé une réunion pour l'annoncer aux gens.
Thank you, Mr. Witness. Do you recall what your announcement was?
Qu'avez-vous annoncé? Réponse.
It was the same information as you
j'ai annoncé la même chose, à savoir ce que vous avez lu, autrement dit, les instructions reçues à l'autre réunion sur ce qui se passait si quelqu'un cassait une houe, une charrette à bœuf ou encore...
Mr. Witness, I'm not sure we're understanding each other fully. So, to assist the process, I'm going to read to you again a little further from your DCCAM statement, where you elaborated in some detail on what your announcement was. Mr. President, once again, this is E3/9149. The ERNs are the same as last time, but just for the reference, it is 01116151 in English. 00731250 in Khmer, and in French it is 01101036. Mr. Witness, this is what you told to DCCAM. Quote, I could not tolerate such an announcement, so I called all the people in the whole commune to a meeting. There were about 500 or 600 people who came to that meeting. I said that the reason people stole cassavas and rice was because they were poor and hungry. They were hungry because we could not produce enough food to feed them. It was not right to accuse people of being enemies because a plow was broken. Mr. Witness, does this refresh your memory about the announcement that you made at a subsequent meeting of the people?
Ce que vous avez vous-même annoncé à l'époque au cours d'une autre réunion.
Bah,
réponse.
Yes, that jogs my memory.
Oui,
I
cela me rafraîchit la mémoire. J'ai assisté à cette réunion.
Mr. Witness, in the DCCAM statement, you say
dans
that not only did you attend
DCCAM,
such a meeting, but you were the one that made the announcement, explaining that you could not tolerate the way that your deputy district secretary had defined enemies. Does that refresh your memory? Is that what happened?
Est-ce que c'est cela qui s'est passé? Réponse.
As I've stated in my previous statement,
comme je l'ai déjà indiqué,
I held a meeting to make
j'ai convoqué une réunion pour
annoncer
cela aux gens.
Thank you, Mr. Witness. I think we understand
Merci.
Each other now.
À présent, je pense que
and
nous
after
nous comprenons.
You made this announcement,
vous avez
were
donc
you punished?
Annoncé cela. Avez-vous ensuite été puni?
But
réponse.
No.
Non.
I was not.
Do you know why not? Question. Did somebody say something to you?
Et savez-vous pourquoi vous ne l'avez pas été? Quelqu'un vous a-t-il dit quelque chose à ce propos?
Not they.
Réponse.
No.
Non. Personne ne m'a rien
said
dit.
Anything to me.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Witness.
La défense. Merci, monsieur le témoin.
Further down in your DC CAM interview, you elaborate a little bit more about this meeting where you made this announcement to the people. So I would like to read you those details now and see how you can comment on those. Mr. President, again, this is E39149, and the ERNs are the same as last time, except for the KMAI, which is now 00731251. Mr. Witness, this is what you told DCCAM. Quote, and this is regarding this meeting at which you made the announcement. Quote,
vous avez fait cette annonce.
This was my own initiative.
C'était ma propre initiative.
He, and here I think you're referring to your district deputy secretary, reported on me to the upper level.
Il m'a dénoncé à l'échelon supérieur.
But he was not successful.
Mais il n'a pas réussi.
My idea was in line with that of the zone and higher echelon. I took the upper echelon's position that wherever the livelihood of the people was better, he who was in charge of that place was doing a good job. Unquote.
Le responsable d'une région.
So, Mr. Witness, my question is as follows. You say that your idea was in line with the zone and the higher echelon, and then you talk about the upper echelon's position when it came to the livelihood of the people. What I would like to know is, can you tell us more about what your understanding of the upper echelon's position was?
Comment vous avez perçu la position de l'échelon supérieur? Réponse.
I did not have a full knowledge about the position of the upper
echelon. Je ne connaissais pas entièrement la position de l'échelon supérieur.
Can you elaborate any more on the statement that you made earlier to DCCAM, where you described it as follows? Wherever the livelihood of the people was better, he who was in charge of that place was doing a good job. What do you mean by livelihood of the people?
Les conditions de vie étaient meilleures, faisait un bon travail. Qu'entendez-vous par les conditions de vie? Réponse.
Livelihood of the people refers to the food that they receive.
Les conditions de vie concernent la nourriture distribuée aux gens.
And how did you know that this was the upper echelon's position?
Comment saviez-vous que telle était la position de l'échelon supérieur? Le président, témoin, avez-vous compris la question? Veuillez répondre. Réponse du témoin. Je n'ai pas bien compris la question. Cela étant, je maintiens ce que j'ai déclaré.
Okay, Mr. Witness. So my question was not about the upper echelon's position as such, but about how you knew of it. Was it because you heard it at a meeting? Did you read it in a document?
Vous en avez connaissance?
Can you comment on this?
Vous l'avez entendu à une réunion? Vous avez lu cela dans un document? Pouvez-vous préciser? Réponse.
I learned of the position of the upper echelon through the announcement over the radio.
C'est par une annonce radiodiffusée que j'ai eu connaissance de la position de l'échelon supérieur.
Through the
une annonce à la radio ou encore
the zone and the sector
par
levels.
Les messages diffusés au niveau de la zone.
Thank you, Mr. Witness. When you talk about messages
question.
Delivered from the zone and sector level, how were these messages delivered? Were they delivered in telegrams? Are you talking about meetings? Can you elaborate?
Était-ce des télégrammes? Était-ce des réunions? Veuillez préciser. Réponse.
It was through meetings.
À l'occasion de réunions.
There is the meetings held at the sector level, or when the sector representatives came to hold meetings at the district level.
Lorsque des représentants de secteur siégeaient au niveau du secteur.
And just one last question on this, and then we'll move on to the next line of questioning.
When you talk about meetings at the sector level,
can you tell me who
attended
those meetings?
Qui y assistait?
In the
meetings, there were representatives from the sector and the zone levels.
Des représentants du niveau du secteur et de la zone.
Thank you, Mr. Witness.
La défense. Merci, Monsieur le témoin.
So now I'm going to move on to my next line of questioning.
Je passe à
and
la série de
I'm going
suivantes.
To ask you a little bit more about the upper echelon,
je vais vous interroger
but
plus avant
I'm going
sur
to be moving
supérieurs.
Away from your experience in Barre District
nous n'allons plus parler de votre
to focus on your
Barre,
earlier experience in Tangkok District.
De votre expérience antérieure
now,
au
Mr. Witness,
Tramkok.
Earlier this afternoon, the international prosecutor
plutôt
referred
matin,
to the fact that in Tet Sambat's book, Behind the Killing Fields, you spoke about a meeting
fields,
with Pol Pot during the DK period.
Avec Pol Pot sous
now,
le
I understand that you
démocratie.
Said that you do not recall that meeting,
vous avez dit
but I want to try to see if I can refresh your memory
réunion,
on that point by reading you the passage from the book, as the prosecutor was unable to read earlier. Mr. President, I will be referring here to the book Behind the Killing Fields, which was mentioned earlier today. The document number is
E3/4202.
It's a book by Gina Chun and
Tet Sambat
from 2010. And the ERNs I will be reading from are, in English, 00757529, in Khmer, 00853 35, and in French 00 84 94 32. Mr. Witness, this is what is recorded
voici
in the book
ce qui
by Chon and Sambat,
ce livre de Chon et de
Sambat, according to an interview with you. Quote,
et ce, sur la base d'un entretien avec vous.
During
cite,
a visit by Pol Pot,
au cours d'une visite de Pol Pot,
brother number one saw dozens of people being transported in trucks
des dizaines de
to
personnes
Kampong
transportées
province.
En camion vers Kampong
they were headed to their execution.
Partaient pour leur
Pol
exécution.
Pot asked
Pol Pot
where the people were being taken
où ces gens étaient emmenés
and who had given the order
avait
to move
donné
them.
L'ordre de les transférer.
You, it says your name here, but
votre
we're not going to
ici,
say that in court. You said
citer,
in an interview that you were surprised Pol Pot didn't know. He had assumed,
Pol Pot
you had assumed, that is, that brother number one had given the directive.
Avoir donné l'ordre.
Unquote.
Fin de citation.
Mr. Witness, I hope you could follow that quote.
J'espère que vous avez pu
my question
suivre.
Here is now, what I'm interested in, Mr. Witness, is what you said about Pol Pot. And what I would like to know is it correct that, according to what you knew, Pol Pot did not seem to know where dozens of people were being taken and who had given the order to move them?
Gens étaient transférés et qui en avait donné l'ordre? À savoir des dizaines de personnes ainsi transférées? Réponse.
Je ne peux pas vous répondre
car je n'ai pas souvenir des événements.
No problem, Mr. Witness. I will move on to my next, and I think it's my last line of questions.
Dernière série de questions, probablement.
So the questions now are going to be referring back to another issue that was discussed by the international prosecutor this morning, namely the so-called purges of the North Zone.
Ce qu'on appelle les purges de la zone.
Mr. Witness, I would like to start by discussing with you part of your DC CAM interview, which the prosecutor has already discussed with you today.
Il d'un
and he also played part of this interview to you in an audio clip.
Et un extrait vous a été diffusé.
Bear with me. I would like to read you the quote again to refresh your memory, and I'll be asking you about different aspects
je
of this quote.
Essayer de vous rafraîchir la
Mr.
Mémoire.
President, this is the DC CAM interview again.
À nouveau,
it is
E3/9149.
The ERNs I will be referring
les
to in this case are, in English, 01-11-61-53. In Khmer,
00-73-12-53.
And in French,
the ERN
is 01-10-10-39. Mr. Witness, here is the discussion that I will quote to you. Quote,
je cite.
The interviewer Long Dani says,
question de Long
so when you were a district secretary,
quand vous étiez secrétaire,
did the sector
de district,
order you to remove anyone?
Est-ce que le secteur vous a ordonné de retirer qui que ce soit? Et votre réponse?
I argued with the old cadres in Barai district. They intimidated me in my district
je me suis
because there was no removal of the old cadres under my watch.
De ils m'ont the old cadres had to be removed,
and they asked why I had not removed
ma
them.
Aucun ancien
I asked
été
them as to how I could remove
les
them if they led the people and had never opposed us or had any conflict. So I found no reason to remove them.
Je leur ai demandé comment
I said that
pu les retirer
three or five times. Mr. Witness, and then you say a little later, there were orders from the upper echelon to arrest those who opposed us. Unquote. Mr. Witness, the part of this comment of yours that I'm interested in is the very last part, when you say that there were orders from the upper echelon to arrest those who opposed us.
A été donné par l'échelon supérieur tendant à arrêter ceux qui s'opposaient.
Do you remember how you received this order from the upper echelon to arrest those who opposed us? As before, for example, was it a meeting? Was it in a document you received? Can you comment?
Était-ce à l'occasion d'une réunion? Est-ce que ça figurait dans un document qui vous aurait été remis? Réponse.
Did not issue such order.
Je n'ai pas donné un tel ordre.
And in fact, the people from the sector came to the area by themselves.
Les gens du secteur sont arrivés sur place.
They asked me about the matter, and I said that I did not have a full grasp of the situation.
J'ai dit que je ne maîtrisais pas pleinement la situation.
Mr. Witness, I understand that you did not issue the order.
Je comprends que ce n'est pas vous qui avez donné cet ordre.
Who do you know who issued the order?
Savez-vous qui l'a fait?
Since it was not you. Is it these people from the sector that came to the area that you're talking about, or is it someone else?
Les gens du secteur arrivés sur place, ou étaient-ce d'autres gens?
As I said, the sector came to the area by themselves.
Comme je l'ai dit, les gens du secteur sont arrivés par eux-mêmes sur place.
And do you recall who from the sector came to the area?
Quels gens du secteur sont arrivés sur place? Réponse.
Yes, I stated earlier it was Eun.
Comme je l'ai dit, c'était Eun.
And just for confirmation, Eun is the sector secretary. Is that correct?
Confirmer que Eun était le secrétaire du secteur.
Eun.
Réponse. Yes, Eun was the sector secretary.
Eun était le secrétaire du secteur.
And do you recall how often
question.
He came to your area?
À quelle fréquence se rendait-il dans, à l'endroit où vous étiez?
Mao.
Once in a while, he came to my area,
il,
and that happened every 20 days or once a month.
Une fois par mois ou tous les 20 jours environ.
And what did he do
question.
When he came to the area?
Quand il se rendait sur place, que faisait-il? Réponse.
As I said earlier.
Comme je l'ai déjà dit.
When he came to the area, he
quand
questioned
il venait,
to me.
Il me posait des questions.
He met with the deputy
il
secretary.
Rencontrait le secrétaire adjoint.
He asked questions. He asked
il
him
posait
questions
des questions à cette personne également. Question.
And apart from these visits by the sector secretary Eun to your area, did you also have communication with him when he was in another location? Did you, for example, did you communicate back and forth
par
about
exemple,
what was happening in the area in between his visits of every 20 days?
Au sujet de la situation de votre endroit entre ces visites qui avaient lieu une fois tous les 20 jours?
No, that's not the case.
Non.
Thank you, Mr. Witness.
La défense. Merci, Monsieur le témoin.
Now, my final questions relate
Dernière
to another part
question,
of the book, Behind the Killing Fields, that you discussed with the prosecutor earlier.
Fields,
and this is the part where you talk about receiving a list of more than 300 names.
Vous dites avoir reçu une liste
now,
de
I know that
noms.
As you testified to the prosecutor, you do not remember
vous
receiving such a list.
Ne pas
but what I would like to do is to read the quote back to you again to see if I can refresh your memory, as I would like to ask you different kinds of questions about this quote. Mr. President,
Monsieur
this is the book Behind the Killing Fields again
Killing Fields,
by Chonin Samba from 2010.
De
the document number is
2010/E3/4202
and the ERNs are
les ERN
in English 00757529 in Khmer 00858383 and in French 00854 94 3283. Mr. Witness, you've heard it before, but here is the quote again. Quote:
In
1977, Kepal called him to a meeting. Him is you in this case, I believe, and said that you had received instructions from top leaders to investigate their cadre to find bad components. A regional chief gave you a list of more than 300 names of people sent to your area from Phnom Penh. You spent 3 months investigating the names before you told the region chief that they had done nothing wrong. The region chief blamed you for finding no wrongdoing and accused you of hiding the traitors,
de n'avoir trouvé aucune faute et l'a accusé de cacher les traîtres. Fin de citation.
Mr. Witness, the part that I am interested in this quote,
Monsieur
is the second part of your statement, where you talk about receiving a list from a region chief,
reçu une liste
reporting to that region chief, and subsequently being blamed by that region chief. My first question is,
accusé.
Do you remember the name of this region chief that you reported to?
Vous souvenez-vous du nom de ce responsable régional à qui vous avez fait rapport?
It was the same person, that is
Eun. Réponse, c'était la même personne, à savoir Eun.
Did Eun tell you why you had to investigate the names on the list?
Dit pourquoi vous deviez mener des enquêtes sur les noms figurant sur cette liste.
I did not have full knowledge about this matter.
Je n'avais pas toutes les informations.
Okay, Mr.
Sujet.
Witness, let me try it a little bit differently. Did Eun tell you that you had to investigate the names because of an order? And if he did, can you tell me where the order came from? According to
l'ordre donné, si oui, pouvez-vous nous dire qui avait donné cet ordre, selon Eun?
I did not know, and Eun never showed me the list.
Eun ne m'a jamais montré la liste.
Okay, Mr. Witness, and in the quote that I read you, the final part of it, in the final part of it, you said that the region chief blamed you because you did not find any wrongdoing, and then you were subsequently accused by the region chief of hiding traitors. Now, when you say that the region chief Eun blamed you, can you tell me what happened to you? Were you punished in some way?
Qu'il vous a reproché, qu'il vous a fait des reproches. Qu'est-ce qui vous est arrivé?
No, there was nothing happened.
Réponse.
And again, did anybody explain to you why? Why nothing happened to you?
Ne m'est arrivé. Question. Quelqu'un vous a-t-il expliqué pourquoi il ne vous était rien arrivé?
Because I never
Réponse.
Received it, and I never committed any wrongdoing that formed the basis of any possible arrest to me.
Thank you very much, Mr. Witness, for your patience. Mr. President, I have no further questions.
Contre moi, la défense. Merci, Monsieur le témoin, pour votre patience. Monsieur le Président, je n'ai plus de questions.
President, it is now appropriate time for a break. The chamber will take a 20 minutes break from now.
Pour nous de prendre une pause de 20 minutes.
Somjian Krabcha.
Suspension de l'audience.